Hello everybody, welcome again to another video by yours truly, Big Black 420i. Today I'm going to be doing one of my first long cross-country videos from straight up point A, point B, no blocks in between. So from here I'm going to start and you're going to see this all the way through, all the way to my destination. I've been wanting to do videos like that lately, and I started to get tired of making some of the shorter videos that's so far on my channel. So I figured let me move up to full-fledged and see what happens. Right now, as you can see, I am hauling a green tractor. All right, my tractor is going to El Centro, and that's where it's going. Now, I'm pretty sure some of y'all have noticed my truck being half red or mostly red. Relax. That's not mechanical damage or body damage. I just have not changed my tires yet. Alright, so that's how much hauling I've done. All of that damage you see there is all tires only. So there won't be any mechanical issues during this trip. Unless one of those tires ended up popping, then that might be an issue. But so far, I haven't seen anybody have a popped tire yet. So without further ado, let's get this here going. Damn, where are you running? Sweet. I will admit, I may not do too much commentary during this video because I kind of just get into the drive and I just enjoy it. I'm just quiet. I get into what I'm doing. But I will try to work on some of it. Every time I come across the crossing, there's always one train and no cars behind. See, I love it online because I don't have to worry about traffic. You know what I'm saying? Because that mini map on my dash tells me what's coming. So I don't have to go through the whole hassle of having to change my view, having to look around. That's one of the big conveniences of playing online. Okay, apparently I got that bit mixed up. G27 as well, so if you happen to hear any noise or a little bit of chatter, that's what you hear. That's my G27 gun. A little louder these days. I skipped a couple of gears there. I do that every now and then depending on circumstances. Sometimes it's not necessary to go through all of your fears, especially if you're not loaded. But in my case, since I am loaded, but I had enough momentum to where I could jump the gear into. Never mind jumping a gear or two. As long as circumstances call for it, I will say that. If circumstances don't call for it, don't try and jump gears. Judging by what I just saw on my mini-map, someone just crashed. Or, I don't know who it was, but whoever it was, they crashed really, really hard. Wait till I get to upgrade the RAM in my computer. I mean, I've got plenty of RAM now and a 4GB graphics card, but I just want to add a little bit more so this way it makes my recordings that much more smoother. Because I was told that recording programs do take up a lot more RAM than just the game itself. So hopefully soon I'll be able to correct all of that. Funny, you don't hear anything when you're at idle. Oh, so I guess I forgot to do that. Thank you.
come up here and smash somebody and not expect nothing coming.
I changed lanes for you. Type of trips with my Peterbilt 379 eventually, because honestly, on a long trip without any music, the sound of that engine would do just fine. But this engine here is like this, there's just no turbo whistle. If you're sitting at idle, truck sounds like it's off. Excuse me? Truck sounds like it's off? I mean, I don't know. I mean, the truck itself is good. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love the truck, but if only they would just do something with the sound of it, or at least allow sound mods to be playable online. You know? It would be nice if we could at least have some sound mods that would be allowed to play online, because honestly, this hurts. there's no real other way to put it.
Actually start the truck back up. It simply did not want to start. Alright, he literally totaled it from head to toe. It was bad. Sure enough, you know, I didn't want to deal with the people anymore. managed to get my truck fixed and travel 100 miles out to my drop-off. Go to find out that same convoy found me. Found me at my drop-off and harassed me to join the convoy again. Well, they didn't like what they was told when I didn't like the fact that they followed me and stuff, still harassing me and stuff, so they ended up telling the admins that I was ramming people. I got kicked very quickly and had to be out for quite a few days because a little child wanted to lie because they didn't get their way. So, that's one matter of fact. That's the main reason why I'm now doing filming and stuff like this now. Because I'm not just doing this just to make the video. I'm also doing this to watch my own tail in case someone was trying to pull something. I have proof that it wasn't me. I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. Which is also a message to some of the other drivers that's out there that plays this game. You know, if you think you're gonna get online and try to start ramming people or think you can lie somebody off the server and things, think again. Because the more bull somebody goes through, don't think they gotta get kicked in order to wanna do this. Alright? If a person gets tired of dealing with something and they got a camera hooked up to their unit like I have right now, trust me, there ain't nothing that you're gonna do that's gonna get out of that, because the camera ain't gonna lie. Alright. If you did it, you did it, and it shows that you did it. So that's one thing that some of y'all wanna be thinking about being troublemakers out there. Think about that. Looks like I gotta get off of this exit.
Roger that. I was trying to move out of Petty's way because he was slowing down and he was late.
Thank you very much.
10-4.
Now that's one guy almost hitting my load. And see, that's the whole thing. When you're inside of a truck, there is no need to go flying people. I mean, why are you speeding like that? I mean, speeding going in a straight line is one thing, but you guys are going through town, you know what I mean? That's not necessary. I mean, if you guys slam on your brakes that darn hard to avoid somebody at an intersection, just maybe something's wrong. Here's a nice little convoy right here.
Acho que tá.
5 miles an hour, actually. I'm going to set my cruise control at this. A little distracted over here. I'm trying to find my ashtray. You know, I gotta say, this is some really beautiful. I like to use different views when I drive this. I don't want to just stay in like one view because there's so much things to see and so many different perspectives to see it in. In my eyes, it kind of deprives the simulator to not show at least some of its different viewing features and stuff, you know? So that's what I'm doing here now. This view here is a bit harder to drive in, I will admit. I highly suggest that anybody who does try driving this view, do it by yourself on the road. Make sure there's nobody next to you, because you are never going to keep that thing directly in your lane. As you can see, I'm drifting a little bit, but for the most part, holding it. I haven't been down that side of the road, or on this road, for that matter. For those who have problems rear-ending people or slowing down at to get off the highway, just do what I did. Downshift. Go of the gas pedal and let the truck do the rest, because right there was no brakes at all. No brakes. Alright, all that was strictly jig braking and downshifting. That's it. You know what I'm saying? It's not hard to slow these trucks down. You know what I'm saying? Especially, you know, even if you're going Mach 5, like I know how some of y'all like to drive. You let the truck do what it's supposed to do, it'll do it for you every single time without any type of hassle or craziness. You know what I'm saying? I mean, a truck, you just need patience with it. I am not gonna miss my opportunity again to get fuel. Gonna look a little rough, but seeing as how I'm inside of a larger truck, I'm pretty sure y'all will understand about how I had my trailer kind of jump the curb back there a little bit to get up inside this pump. nice and fueled up. Time to roll out. Sorry, driver. I didn't see you in time when I came out. Destination. Let's change the view here up a little bit. Alright. They want me to put it inside the barn. Oh, dude. See, I hate it when people spawn in different places, you know what I'm saying? Even if you are in a non-collision zone, I hate it when people just spawn out of nowhere. I can't tell you how many times people have told me they got kicked for random people. When people forget the fact that some of these people show up or save their games in weird spots, like in the middle of a highway, in the middle of the road. I'm like, yo, want to do things on the road or on the highway, but pull over to the side of the road before you go ahead and do that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I know he's like in the non-collision zone, spot like that, yo, but still, you know what I'm saying? To have stuff just pop up like that as you're moving, I'm not gonna say any surprise.
right. It may not be perfect, but it's in the space. Well, everybody, this concludes our video. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like. If you have any suggestions, please leave the comments. And if you want to see future videos, please subscribe. Until the next video, until then, Big Black 420i signing off. Until I see you next time, happy trucking.